Philippine National Security Advisor says a newly created U.S. military task force will not deploy American troops to join Philippine operations in the Ayungin Shoal. But an activist group denounced the task force as American interference in Philippine sovereign affairs. Bianca Dava has tonight's top story.
National Security Advisor Secretary Eduardo Anyo said on Thursday that U.S. Task Force Ayungin only provides support to armed forces of the Philippines' operations in Ayungin Shoal and has no direct participation in rotation and resupply missions to the BRP Sierra Madre. The World War II-era ship is grounded on Ayungin and is Manila's lone military outpost in the West Philippine Sea.
They're providing support to us, like, for example, ISR, Maritime Domain Awareness. So, tumutulong sila sa pagbibigay ng mga information about that. But on actual direct participation, it is purely, solely a Philippine armed forces, I mean Philippine forces operation. The WESCOM supported by the Philippine Coast Guard.
In a statement, the U.S. Embassy said the task force enhances U.S.-Philippine alliance coordination and interoperability by enabling U.S. forces to support AFP activities in the South China Sea. The initiative also aligns with multiple lines of cooperation between Manila and Washington, including the Mutual Defense Board Security Engagement Board and the Bantay Dagat Framework. In a separate statement, the AFP said U.S. troops in Palawan provide technical assistance through the Information Sharing Group within the C2 Fusion Center in the Western Command. Anyo did not give details on when the U.S. task force was created, but said that its focus is not just centered on Ayungin Shoal.
That is internal to the side of the U.S. We have the U.S.-Philippine cooperation through the MDT. We have agreed actions taken for the whole year. So this is not centered just on Ayungin. It is, kumbaga, lahat ng aspect ng MDT, SEB, ang ating collaboration with the U.S. forces.
The Progressive Coalition Pilipinong Nagkakaisa para sa Soberanya called the presence of the U.S. task force a form of interference by Washington. PINAS spokesperson Antonio Tino said this just shows that the Marcos Jr. administration is dependent on U.S. input in handling the West Philippine Sea issue. Meanwhile, the U.S. House of Representatives has passed a resolution calling for more joint patrols in the South China Sea, not only between Manila and Washington, but with other like-minded partners as well. U.S. House Resolution No. 837, introduced by Congressman James Moylum, also expressed opposition to China's false sovereignty claims to the South China Sea. The measure also reaffirmed America's unwavering commitment to Manila's defense in case of an armed attack against Filipino assets. China's Coast Guard and maritime militia have been harassing, blocking, and executing dangerous maneuvers on Philippine vessels conducting legitimate maritime operations in the West Philippine Sea. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.